Hey, what's going on? This is Sarah Lee Day, and you're watching Dubsado Tidbits, the things you need to know about Dubsado delivered in bite-sized pieces. Today, we're going to talk about email setup. And this is a question that I get a lot, and I see a lot, is how do I set up my email so that emails sent from Dubsado are actually looking like they're coming from my account versus a like mail at Dubsado account? So let's take a look at that. Go up here to the gear icon. Then click emails on the left. Now we have two options here. We can sign in with a Google email address, or if we don't have Google, then we'll have to use this SMTP option. I'm actually going to show both ways, but we're going to break it up into parts. So today I'm going to focus on signing in with Google. First, you want to enter your login information. Then just follow the on-screen prompts. Dubsado wants to access your Google account. They'll be able to view your email messages and settings and send email on your behalf. Yes, we definitely want it to do that. So allow. And that's it. Now we're all set. It shows that we're connected here. And all replies to emails originating from Dubsado will appear in both your Dubsado and also your normal inbox. So a lot of people get kind of confused by this. So what that means is anytime that you send an email out from Dubsado, whether it's sending a contract, proposal, anything in your workflows, if and when a customer responds to that email, you will see that response in both your regular email account. So in this case, I'll see that in my Gmail account, and you will also see it in your Dubsado account. Now, we won't go into the details about that right now, but just know that and keep that in the back of your mind for later. We'll see that when we actually get into projects and examples and workflows, we'll see those email messages coming into both the external inbox and also the Dubsado inbox. Now, this tracking pixel allows you to track whether or not emails have been opened. That's a really awesome feature. It doesn't always show. There may be some settings on the user side, so on your client side, that are blocking this pixel from working. But from what I've seen and what I've experienced, most of the time when you have this tracking pixel turned on, you can actually see when your emails are being delivered to your clients, when they've actually opened the emails, and if they've actually read the emails. Which is a pretty awesome thing because a lot of times, especially for clients who maybe aren't going to go with your services, if they don't respond to you, you don't know, hey, did they not like my proposal or did they not read my proposal? And with this tracking pixel, you can actually see if they've even opened and read the email, versus, well, they just haven't gotten to it yet, or perhaps it got lost in filters. That's also a possibility. And that's it as far as setting up your Gmail account through Dubsado. If you're not using Gmail, then don't worry. I am still going to cover the next part of this in the next video. So everyone else who's using an SMTP server, that's going to be in the next video. It's going to be a little bit different. There's a little more to it, but we can still definitely get it set up. So that's it for today's tidbit. For more information about receiving updates, requesting future episodes, or getting help with your own Dubsado account, check out the links in the description below this video or visit SarahLeeDay.com. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.